talk about fasting today. It's something a lot of you had a lot of queries and questions about, and we have been putting it off for quite some time now. So let's talk about the what, why, and how of fasting. So what is fasting? So fasting is basically the absence of food in a prescribed period of time. As humans, we are used to eating from the time we wake up until the time we go to bed. We are used to eating. We have breakfast, we have a snack, we have lunch, we have a snack, we have dinner, and then sometimes we have a midnight snack also. So the body is constantly involved in the process of digestion. The organs are constantly involved in the process of digestion. So most of the energy in our body is spent for this process of digestion, and other vital functions and the body's organs are not able to detox from the constant process of digestion which is happening in the body. So fasting is a good way to detox and give your body a break from this constant process which is happening inside the body. So why fast? What are the benefits of fasting? One of the biggest benefits and one of the reasons why people try their hand at fasting is for weight loss. Second thing is it improves a lot of metabolic conditions in the body. For example, it reduces insulin resistance, it reduces high blood cholesterol, it reduces high blood pressure. So these are the advantages or benefits of fasting at a very basic level. Other than this, one of the biggest advantages of fasting is that it increases the amount of human growth hormone in the body. Now, HGH or human growth hormone is normally found in the body. It is very high in children. But as we age, after the age of 30 years, there is a sharp decline in the amount of human growth hormone in the body. So, human growth hormone basically improves fat loss, increases the amount of muscle that you can gain, and also slows down the aging process. So these are the benefits of having more human growth hormone in the body. Now fasting increases the amount of human growth hormone to a very large extent. So that is one of the benefits. Next thing is something called as autophagy. Now what is autophagy? For example, look at the cells. Now when you consume food, the food is broken down into glucose, and this glucose is taken to all the cells, and the cells utilize this glucose as food for themselves to carry out their processes. Now when you're fasting, since you have not eaten food, there is no glucose being sent to the cells after a few hours, right? So the cell is looking for food to eat, and it cannot find glucose outside, so it starts to look for food within itself. So what does it do? It starts breaking down the toxins or the bad substances inside the cell itself and starts to use that for energy. So in a sense, what is it doing? It is detoxing, internally detoxing. So by fasting, you are increasing this process of autophagy, where the cells are rejuvenating and detoxing internally. So this is supposed to be one of the biggest benefit of fasting. Next thing is, fasting has a very major effect on brain health. So by the year 2050, statistics say that more than 15 million people world over will end up struggling with Alzheimer's and other neurodegenerative disorders. So a lot of us don't pay attention to neurodegenerative disorders because you think it is a process of the, it's an aging process. So it is a part of the aging process, which it is not. It is possible to stay with completely good cognitive function until the day you die. But you need to pay attention to certain things for you to improve your brain health. So fasting is one such thing which helps you to keep your brain health better. So what does it do? By fasting, you are inducing a small energetic stress on the brain. So this stress will promote the production of what is known as BDNF, or brain-derived neurotrophic factor. Now this BDNF increases the survival of the existing neurons and also promotes the formation of new nerve cells or neurons in the brain. So this helps to keep a lot of neurodegenerative disorders at bay. So other than this, there are few other benefits of fasting which actually kick in very long-term fasts, somewhere between 36, 72 hours and beyond. So people who fast for such extended days and hours reap other benefits also. So one of the things is the production of stem cells in the gut. Now stem cells are cells which are found in the body naturally, and they help with repair, regeneration and healing. They increase the healing potential of the body. So what happens is, When you fast, the gut produces more of these stem cells, and this helps with healing of lot of autoimmune disorders like leaky gut syndrome, ulcerative colitis, and things like this. So these are the many benefits of fasting. There are some other molecular level benefits also, like for example, the effect on mTOR and things like that, but that is not something which I can discuss at length now. So let's limit ourselves to the benefits that we can understand and we can perceive because of fasting. So how can I incorporate fasting into my lifestyle? So if you are someone who is new to fasting, the best protocol for you to follow will be what is called as the intermittent fasting protocol. So intermittent fasting is a protocol where you have a feeding window and a fasting window. So the very basic thing will be a 12:12 feeding and fasting window, where you are eating for 12 hours and you are fasting for 12 hours. So for example, if you have eaten at 7 p.m. last night, you will next eat at 7 a.m. the next day. So you have fasted for 12 hours. So once you get comfortable with this, then you can move on to a 14:10 fasting window, where 14 hours you fast and 10 hours you eat. Again, once your body adapts to this, you're comfortable with this, then you can move on to a 16:8 IF protocol, where you fast for 16 and you eat for 8 hours. So these are the things where you can slowly adapt yourself by increasing the number of hours that you fast. Now 16:8 is a very common protocol, and it is something which is doable on a daily basis. There are people who also follow the 20:4 protocol, where they are fasted for 20 hours and they eat for 4 hours, which is a little difficult to incorporate for most people, but 16:8 is something doable. So you can start from 12:12 and then slowly move on to 16:8. So this is intermittent fasting. So you can start your journey by following the intermittent fasting protocol. So now there are two very important things that I would like to remind you about any kind of fasting. First thing is, just because you're fasting, it doesn't mean that you can eat how many ever calories you want during the feeding window. So whatever your fasting time be, your feeding window should be, you should be consuming the amount of calories that you actually require, not under and not over. So just because you're fasting doesn't give you the green signal to eat how much ever you want during the feeding window. This becomes a counterintuitive process. Next thing is the kind of food that you are eating during your feeding window. So because you're fasting doesn't mean you can treat yourself to a pizza or two slices of cake during your feeding window. It just breaks down the entire point of putting yourself on a fasting protocol. The whole point of fasting is for you to improve your internal system, and in the process also lose weight. So if you are putting processed, packaged foods, high salt, high sugar foods into your body with empty calories, there is really no point in undertaking a fast also. Fasting should bring in some amount of discipline into your feeding patterns, and in the long run help you in weight loss. So these are the two very important things. So next question is, what are the things am I allowed to consume during my fast? So during your fast, you cannot consume anything which has calories in it. So what are the things you can eat? Simple, you can have as much water as you please. You can have black coffee, you can have black tea, and you can have green tea. So these are the very simple things which do not have calories that you can consume. So having tender coconut water, fresh fruit juice, etc., etc., is not acceptable, because all these contain calories and they will throw you out of your fast. So the whole point is, you don't want glucose, any calories, to enter your body which can be converted into glucose. You want to your body to stay in a state where it can utilize the fat in your body and not keep utilizing the glucose that you are putting in your body through food. So you can consume water, black tea, black coffee, and you can consume green tea. So my favorite is water and green tea. Green tea especially has compounds called catechins. Now catechins help to increase the body's metabolism and improve your weight loss. So it's a small added benefit, but when it's added along with your fast, this probably is a better idea to have green tea during your fasting window. So these are the things. Now who cannot be fasting? First of all, people who are brittle diabetics. Who's a brittle diabetic? A person whose blood sugar levels spike suddenly and fall suddenly. So it's very risky for such people to embark on fasting without any guidance from a healthcare professional. So if you are a diabetic or have any other health issues, please speak to your healthcare professional first and then get their help and guidance so that they can modify your medications, etc., and then help you on this journey. Do not embark without any guidance. Second thing is children and adolescents and people over the age of 70 years, it's not a good idea for you to be fasting. Third thing is pregnant and women who are lactating, this is not the right time for you to start a fasting protocol. There is always a time for you to start this later on once this your pregnancy and lactation period are over. Next thing is people who struggle with eating disorders. Fasting is not a good idea for people who have eating disorders. It can aggravate your symptoms, so do not embark on it if you have a history of eating disorders. Please get guidance and help first. Next is people who have been recently hospitalized or people whose BMI is very low, your body mass index is very low. So such people also, it is not a good idea for you to fast. So these are the basic things that I wanted to convey through this video. There are a few other things also which I would like to talk about, and I will talk about how fasting is different for men and women and how it affects our bodies differently, and also about what are the foods that you can consume after breaking your fast and things like that. So I will talk to you about that on a later video. So stay safe and stay healthy, guys.